Box, I should say, the mission of the Box, the Outside Theater, is to use the arts for more than just entertainment. They seek to build a community by reaching out through volunteer efforts and reading programs for youth. The group also wants to use the shows, to open the doors for tourists to see the cultural diversity of the Bronx. And artistic director Gene DeFrancis will talk more on the Box, the Outside Theater. And you know,
it's a tricky name, I know.
No, because you know, I had it down pat, and all of a sudden, outside the box, box outside. You know,
it's an emphasis on the BX. Mm-hmm. I always used to have the term "think outside the box." All my teachers would say, "Think outside the box, outside the box." So I said, "Let me be a little different. Let me say it backwards: Box the Outside Think." Mm-hmm. And then we were coming up with the name for the theater group, and I noticed BX standing pretty strong in the word box. Mm-hmm. So we said, let's start with Box, the Outside. And basically our mission is to get people from outside into the Bronx, spend some money, and stimulate our economy here. Mm-hmm. I'm very egocentric that way. I'm a Bronxite, born and raised, went to the Navy, graduated Columbus High School before that, mm-hmm. and wanted to come back and bring something to the community.
So talk about what you brought back to the community, because obviously you've got to be proud of the fact that you're able to bring this back.
Yeah, absolutely. It was actually quite surprising to see how many people were actually involved in the arts. Mm-hmm. You know, friends of mine who graduated public school or high school, who's a director, who's a writer, who's doing something, mm-hmm. or wanting to do something. I got a lot of, I want to become an actor, but I don't know how to start. And that's basically when I said, well, let me share what I learned, because I'm a member of the Screen Actors Guild, Actors Equity, did some great projects with some great performers and just men and women of the arts, and got my MFA at the New School for Drama. And the minute I got out, I said, let's go full force with this theater company and see what we can do. And it was pleasantly surprising how the Bronx welcomed us with open arms. We're on a shoestring budget. We're just getting out of our fetal stage. Mm-hmm. We're in our infant stage right now. And that's why we're gonna start spreading the word more and more nowadays.
Share a little bit about this. You got some reading programs?
We got some reading programs where basically we get new writers, young writers, and established writers. Mm-hmm. They submit their scripts to us, and we do a reading. Invite the public. We did some free readings for kids in the public schools. We went to PS 306 just Wednesday with the Screen Actors Guild. They have a little organization called Book Pals. And I'm talking with Maria Cabeza, who's head of that project, about getting it full force into the Bronx. Stimulate, because as you know, reading is very important to an actor. Mm-hmm. And so we want to make sure that the kids know how to read. That's the first step, reading and breathing. If you can't do either one, acting is not for you. And so basically, we went into the communities. So we're not just focused on one area, specific area, even though most of our projects come out of Mott Haven, in a place called Bruckner Bar and Grill.
Right.
Have you been there?
I haven't been there, but I know about it.
You have to go there.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. If you haven't been to the Bruckner Bar and Grill, it's amazing. Not to sound crude about it, but it seems like you're not in the Bronx, mm-hmm. is what the common phrase is. I can't believe I'm in the Bronx. I feel like I'm in Brooklyn. I feel like I'm in Manhattan or something like that, which is not really what I want. I want the Bronx to maintain its own identity.
Right.
I want to get it into people's heads that they really don't know what the Bronx is and to start coming in.
Mm-hmm. So you talk about people not knowing the Bronx, but they're knowing the Bronx through these programs, knowing the Bronx through, you know, your organization. And I want to ask you about this, because if you got a program coming up, you got that coming up, what is your goal of the program?
Goal of the program is to get people jump-started into the arts. I hear a lot of people talking about, I love the arts, I want to get involved in the arts, but I don't know how. Mm-hmm. And that's the overall mission. Come Sunday to the Bruckner Bar and Grill. They have it's the Bruckner Gallery in the back. And it's 1 Bruckner Boulevard, you can't miss it, 1 o'clock this Sunday. And we're gonna do a couple of ones, absolutely mm-hmm. free. There's no gimmicks, no hidden plot. We wanna build a community. Mm-hmm. We wanna get people involved, we wanna get them on board. And there's not gonna be anyone to tell you that you're a horrible actor. It's just gonna be love and support, meet other actors, established actors, come in and network.
So talk to us about this, the arts as we know it. When you go to schools, particularly New York City public school system, one of the major programs is cut nowadays, music and arts.
It's a tragedy.
Yeah. Do you find right now that you're kind of like filling the gap in being able to do this and just having an artistic program?
It's great that you're saying that. Yes. Mm-hmm. Overall, because if the government doesn't want to support it, which in itself is a crime, all good civilizations have culture in the arts. Mm-hmm. If you're going to succeed, you need the arts. That's just always been my motto, my philosophy. And it's the nucleus. When it founded with the Greeks, that was the nucleus of their democracy, the arts, expression of oneself. They're cutting it. I don't want them to cut it. We're trying to spearhead projects where, you know, we can offer it into the school still. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, you can't just give it away.
Right.
So it's a tricky balance. Mm-hmm. You want to give free arts, but then the actors have to get paid. In other words, is what I'm saying.
Right.
But it needs to exist. Life without arts is just, it's not a way to live.
Well, we encourage you to support the Box, the Outside Theater, and tell us one more time where we can find out more information, what's going on during this.
You could go to our fan page. We're trying to stimulate the fan page, Box the Outside on Facebook, Twitter. You can follow us there. We have a website that we're trying to, it's in construction right now, but it's Box the Outside Theater. Mm-hmm. Or you could just show up to 1 Bruckner Boulevard, the Bruckner Bar and Grill, this Sunday, 1 p.m.
All right, so we encourage you to come on out this Sunday at 1 p.m. and you can find out more. Gene, thank you so much for coming and sharing with us.
Thank you for having me.